Yes, sir.
Yeah, yes. So array implementation of list. So I told that there are two ways by means of which you can implement a list in a C programming language or any programming language. One is by means of array, another by means of pointers. So let us see first how the list is implemented using array. So first of all, when you implement list using array, it is also said as linear data structure. But what is there in terms of memory declaration? So when you use array, the memory declaration as well as the memory allocation is to be static and contiguous in nature. That is, you have to purely say the memory size. Say for example, with respect to the Sweta case, since Sweta has only 5 grocery items, so she has to say in prayer when she is going to use array for implementation of list using C language, that is array size is 5. Like that she has to inform clearly. Jansi has to inform that 3, array size 3. What is the size of Vincent? What is the size of Vincent? How many he says to us? 30, right? So 30 to-do list, like
yes, sir.
He told us. So 30. So likewise, you should say in prayer. So that is static in terms of memory location. So that is, you have to say in prayer. And once you have defined prayerly, you should not modify it. And it is static and it is a constant throughout the implementation, throughout the program, right? That is a static in nature. And the memory allocation, see, whenever an item is there, the allocation is contiguous in nature. That means if you are adding an item first, Sweta has sent about the first item as sugar, second item as chili powder, third item is dal. So that items is one by one in a continuous manner, it has to be the array size is allotted to the items. Right? So if you are trying to insert, say for example, her mother is asking that, no, you insert that is a coffee powder next to sugar. Next, after buying coffee powder, you buy chili powder, you insert the coffee powder, means it is not possible. When you are implementing it is not possible. In handwritten, it is possible by means of simple arrow mark. He create a space and in that space, he add sugar after coffee powder, then only chili powder. But when you are trying to implement it in array, that data cannot be inserted in the middle. That's why the data allocation is contiguous in nature. It cannot be, that means, I didn't say it is not highly impossible, but I am saying that the allocation is one by one. That's what I am saying. Right. And if you want to access element, the element can be accessed individually. Individually, you can access the element. Say, for example, if someone is asking about, asking to Jansi that, who is the second member in your team? Who is the second member in your team? So he can say, she could say that. So second member in the team is Kavita. Like that she can say. So that way you have to say in according to that order, right? So what is the syntax for the array declaration? So you have to declare a data type. The data type may be integer, float, or character like that. And you have to give a name for the array. And then you have to mention the size. And then you have to mention the size. So the size may be 5 in case of Sweta, 3 in case of Jansi, and 30 in case of Vincent. So like that. You have to, so this is the way. Say for example, for all the three, you for all you three people, you have mentioned the items in items not as a number but as a string. So you can mention character array, character, the name in case of Sweta, it is grocery within bracket 5. In case of Jansi, it is character and team within bracket 3. In case of Vincent, it is character to do. That is, you have to give a name. All right, that's it. And within bracket, you have to say the size. And if you could see that the array's dimension may be of single dimension or two dimension. Single dimension or more than one dimension. It may be a two dimension or three dimension. Or in general, multi-dimension. So this is what the prior information you should know about array implementation of list. So how to create that integer array? Let me take the elements are integer numbers. So all three have set about what is that? Character. Let me take an example about integer array. So that is integer. You should mention the data type. Array name A, and you have to specify the size. And within the braces, you have to mention the items. That means the first item is 7, second item, third item, fourth item, fifth item. Likewise, you have to mention all the items. So here A of I, A of 0, A of 1, A of 2. So that way, I equal to 0, I equal to 1. That way, the data is stored. So see, the memory allocation is contiguous. One by one, one by one, one by one, one by one, the data is stored. So if you want to access element, you can specify the name by mentioning the index. Say, for example, if you want to know what is the item that is present in the position 6, then you have to mention A of 6. Then you have to mention A of 6. In A of 6, it is going to be 8. In A of 6, it is going to be 8. In A of 4, it is going to be 0. So likewise, by mentioning the size, you can do this. Remember, the array index always starts with 0. So if you declare array size as a 10, the maximum numbers are 0 to 9. 0 to 9, right? So this is the way, this is the 0 points to the first one and 5 points to the last one. In case if this is a 5 number element, right? So that is the way in which you have to create an array. See, when you are going to study a data structure, you need to study three things. First thing is the diagrammatic representation. First thing is a definition. What is array? First thing you should define, what is array? And the second thing is diagrammatic representation. Second thing is diagram. And the fourth one is condition. See, third one is condition. Here, with respect to array, there is no condition. And the fourth one is operation. And fifth one is special kinds. That means any special type of data structures are available or not. If you have notebook, you can note it down. Definition. So whenever you want to study a data structure, you should define the data structure. And you should be in a position to show the data structure through diagrams. And you want to mention the condition for the data elements, storage, retrieval, insertion, and deletion operation. And you have to mention the operation. What are the operation with respect to array? See, creation operation, traversal operation. That is means traversal is, you can otherwise say that searching. Creation is also otherwise called by the name initialization, like so that is the thing. And apart from that, the two major operations are insertion operation, deletion operation, like that, right? Special kinds, is there any special kind is associated? Say, for example, when you go for a list, you can find many special types, but here in this case, array is only one. So if you want to have a special kinds, maybe to a certain level, you can go for single dimensional array, or you can go for multi-dimensional array, like that you can do. You have to do programs, ADT, special kinds. After the special kinds, you have to say about ADT. After ADT, you have to write code. That is the problem. So these many contents you have to study for every data structure. What is the content you have to study? Definition, diagram, condition, if any, operations of the data structure, is there any special kinds, ADT, code. And finally, one more thing, the thing is application. So you have to study these many things in order to study the data structure. So let me go to the program for the array, that is a creation and a traversal of array, very easier program. So what is the program is saying is, the program is saying that, what is the thing? Yeah, yes. So what is you have to do is, so as usual, so if you know very basic about C, you know that. So here I am not going to teach you C language, just I will say what is this keyword is about, and you have to study the C language on your own. I hope you have studied the C language. If not, you have to refer the C language. So this is the prerequisite information that you should follow, because I will explain only the concept. C coding and all, C background and all, you should study. See, the students, those who come to third semester from first year, first semester, second semester. So in the first semester, in the regular engineering, not you like lateral entry, like regular entry people. So in the first semester, they will study Python. In the second semester, they will study C language. So in the third semester, they are easily comfortable in understanding the code. But you, I expect you that you have little knowledge about the programming language in your polytechnic course. So with this, so I do not want to touch upon the C code. So directly, I want to touch upon the concept. So what is the concept? So in order to create an array, so you have to create a data type, array name, and a list of items. So what I am going to do, just I am going to initialize the array element. So in order to initialize array element, I have to use the for loop. And within the for loop, I have initialized the elements in the for loop. So this is the way in which you can do the elements. So you see here, traversal is not there, but traversal is, what is the traversal? So again, you can use the for loop. Again, you can use for loop. So that for loop, with the help of for loop, if you want to locate any element like L of LA of 2 or LA of 3, so like that you can find without for loop, without the use of for loop, because this is continuously displaying, that is a traversing. It visits the 0th index, visits the first index, visits the second index, visits the third, visits the fourth index, like that. But you can access the element by mentioning the index also. So creation is this step. So this single step is meant for creation, right? And this entire loop is meant for this one. That is the traversal operation. So creation is the only one line. That's it. Traversal is this for loop. Within the for loop, the print statement. That is a traversal operation. Now come to insertion operation. So for insertion operation, first you have to do, you have to create like this. Create an array. Using the other thing, then you have to insert the element. You have to insert the elements, or you have to initialize the elements, or you have to search the traverse the elements. Yes, it is exactly traverse elements. So originally, what are the elements you want to see? Now, if you want to add any element, say for example, the original array is in LEF 01, LEF 13, LEF 2, see, like 135. Now, what I am going to do is, I am going to add 10 in which location? Third location. So, already what number is there in this third location? 7. So, what I have to do? So, I have 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. In 0, I have 1. In 1, I have 3. In 2, I have 5. In 3, I have 7. In 4, I have 8, right? Now, in the place of 7, I have to put 10. So, right? So, what it does, I do not delete 7, but in the place of 7. So, I have to increase one location. I have increased one location. So, now the location is 5. So, after inserting the location 5, what I have to do, I have to bring 8 down. Then 7, one more that down. Now, the 7th location, third location is free. And in that third location, I have to insert the. So this is the logic for doing that thing with the kind of the logic they have. So what is the item that you are going to insert? So item here is mentioned, integer item is 10, right? The item that has been taken, and with the adjustment in the for loop, you have inserted the data item in the specific location. So that's what insertion operation is about. Deletion operation. So what is a deletion operation? So deletion operation is deleting an element from the array by mentioning the index. So as usual, this deletion operation also starts with creation of an array and traversal of array. Now after traversal, if you want to delete an element, say for example, here in 0th location, 1 is there, 1th location, 3, second, like that it goes on. Now if I want to delete the element 5, so what it does, if I want to delete element, this location is free, right? So in order to effectively utilize the location, you have to push 7. You have to make, you have to bring 7 there, and you have to bring 8 here. So this is what the additional operation that you have to do after insertion. So after insertion and deletion, you have to do little operations in order to increase the memory as well as effectively utilize the memory by omitting it. So this is what deletion operation. So the element is taken until the element matches, you are incrementing the counter. Once the match is found, what you have to do is just to delete that element, that location. So this is what deletion operation. So with respect to array, we have studied three, four operation. One is the creation, another one is initialization or traversal, and another one is insertion operation as well deletion operation. So these are the four operation that we have studied in the array implementation of list. My last one is search operation. So you have to search an element. That is, you have to give a location. So you have to give a location. Say for example, n equal to 5. You have to see if again the array is mentioned here. In the for loop, you have to increase the element one by one. So you have to give the element, item. So with the help of the item, not a position, but by the item. Say for example, number 7 is there in the list or not. So what I have to do, I have to take the 7 and I have compare with the 1. So 1 and 7 are compared, whether it is equal, not equal. So you go to next. I compare with the 7 and 3. It is equal, not equal. So with I compare with this 5 and 7, 7 and 7, and 8 and 7. So for all the element, in all the elements are compared, and finally one element is declared as the success. So what is the element that needs to be searched? Item number 5. Where number 5 is there in the location 2 and in the line number 3. So it is mentioned that it is found at position 3. If I want the element 5 and it is find in the position 3. So this is what the search operation is about. So remember, student, insertion, deletion and searching plays the vital role. Of course, for linear data structure, our major focus on insertion and deletion. But for nonlinear data structure, searching plays the vital role because of the facility available and the need that is to be performed, available for doing that task, right? So that is what the thing. What is the limitation of array? Array is a rigid data structure. That is, you have to specify everything in prior. You cannot modify later. You can modify later. And if you want to modify, it is very bigger burden to you. And it is very hard to add or remove elements. See, what is the hard? You need to see, if I want to add an element in one position, what I do? I have to pull all the element down one by one. I create an empty space and in that space insert an element. That's what the first thing. And what is the remove? In order to remove element, after removing the element, the location is make empty. So you have to fill the element with no more element so that you have to make the array compact. So you have to adjust the element with one by one. So that is that. And whatever the operation you are doing, it is requires always a constant time. You may not expect or you may not guarantee a lesser time. Say for example, other implementation, we are not seeing about the other implementation when we are in the first unit and we are in the very first topic. So constant time means whatever the operation, whether insertion, deletion or searching, all the operation consumes a constant or a common time. So there is no variation that time. And another thing, the limitation is it is not dynamic. So there are, of course, you have the concept of dynamic memory allocation. Even then, how the dynamic memory allocation done? It is done with the help of pointers. That's why you go for a pointer rather than the array for implementing the list. That's the topic we are going to discuss after this. Then it is a memory loss. What is the memory loss? If you are deleting the element, that memory will be lost as such. It is the empty space is left as such. So that is another limitation of array. So that is the these are all the points that discuss about the limitations of array. So in order to address the limitation, what one can go for is pointer implementation. The name of the pointer implementation is linked list. So here everything is a dynamic. Array size increase, array size decrease, effective memory utilization is very good, and everything is paka in with respect to linked list. And how a linked list look like? So linked list is by pictorial, by picture, the linked list look like this. See, there should be a head node, and there should be a first node A, and there should be B, and there should be C. That is, you need to assume the data holder as a node, such that the node has two components. One is data component, another one is pointer component. So you have to assume the two portions. So in the data component, you have to assume the data. Say for example, in case of Sweta, the first item is rice, second item is sugar, like that data. And this is the connection to the next component. So what is the next component of Sweta after adding rice? The next component of Sweta is after adding rice. Next component is sugar, right? So sugar is made as another chain. So it looks like a chain. It looks like a chain and it keep on going. where the chain is to be ended. If the NAS node doesn't have any other node to point out, then that link is to be grounded. So in the ground, you can say that in the ground, you say that the list is stopped. The list is after that there is no list. And using, since this linked list is uses dynamic memory allocation, so it can easily grow or shrink the size during the execution. So you can either increase the memory size or you can decrease the memory size accordingly. So that is the idea here. So then it does not, memory space is not wasted because you are going to delete an element with the node is the entire node. We are going to see one by one what is the case required and that, right? Next. Next, array versus list. So what is the in array, inserting and deleting an element at the end, it is possible. Array are suitable for inserting and deleting the element at the end very easily and very easily possible. And you can randomly, by mentioning the array location, you can randomly access the element, but it is not random access, it is sequential access. But here, inserting and deleting element at any location, there only at the end. End is easier. Inserting element at the end and delete the element that is present at the end is easier. But if you want to insert or delete in the middle, then it is a little tougher. You have to adjust the elements, and that's what the example we have seen, the program, right? Then the inserting or deleting an element at any location, sequence access is required. In situation where the number of elements cannot be predicted. So that's also a good one, right? So in situation, see, in Sweta case, she said about 5 elements. In the Jansi case, she said about 3 elements. In Wilson case, she said about 30 elements. So there are certain situation you cannot say, no, I cannot say the things what I have to purchase and what I have to include as a team member and what I have to do. So my list is keep on increasing. I do not say as of now, my list is only 5 or only 3 or only 30. It may be dynamically varying and dynamically increasing. So in that case, we cannot say the number of elements beforehand when you use a linked list, right? That's what the difference between array and a linked list. So types of linked list. So depending on the way in which the links are used, depending on the way. So if you use single, what is meant by link here? That is the line that joining the two nodes. That is the link. So if it is a single link, then it is single linked list. If the links are passing from one side and then it is fine. See, here, what is the difference? If you notice the difference, you see the difference here. So this is grounded. This is grounded. So instead of making the ground, you are again making in the loop is something useful when you are going for some advanced operations, especially with the addition, with the searching and other operations, right? And then the doubly linked list. So doubly linked list, see, you have two arrows. One arrow is pointing forward and one arrow is pointing backward. So also you have a head node and a tail node. So this is what double linked list. So pointer exists between two pointers. So this is the thing you need to understand the different types of linked list. So first thing, single linked list. Second one is circular linked list. So in circular linked list, the pointer from the last element in the list points back to the first element. The pointer from the last element points to the first element, right? That is it. Double linked list. So pointer between adjacent pointers existing between adjacent node in both there. Pointers existing between adjacent nodes in both direction. The list can be traversed either forward or backward. The list can be traversed. See, list means list of items. You can go in this direction or you can go in this direction. So if you say that list of items to be read from the bottom, it is also possible. List of items from the top, it is also possible. That is the benefits in double linked list. And it is having two pointers. One is a head pointer and tail pointer. Head pointer is made to mention beginning of the list. Tail pointer is set to that end of the list. So that is what the type of the list is, right? So tomorrow onwards, we will see the class single linked list, circular linked list, and doubly linked list, right? So if you could see all the three linked lists, then application. So that's what the special kind. So I already told that. So when you study a data structure, first of all, you study what is the data structure and what are the key points of this data structure and how it is diagrammatically represented. So this is one. So, but in addition to that, you have other points also that is to be discussed when you are concluding any data structures, right? Okay. For this, I will close the today's class. I have stopped up to types of lists. Maybe in the other class, we will discuss about the implementation of a single linked list, or studying of various operations of single linked list, as well as a double linked list, and then what is that? Application of linked list, right? So I think I will close the session. I hope you all understand the idea. So let me stop the
recording.
Yes, sir.